Mary L. Trump lived a fairly quiet life until she started speaking out regarding her uncle, former President Donald Trump, during his time in office. She wrote a best-selling book that revealed intriguing Trump family insights, and she became a frequent guest on various talk shows. Mary did not mince words when it came to how she felt about her uncle or the experiences she'd had in the family.
He's comfortable doing heartless things. Clearly, he doesn't seem to be interested in empathy.
What she is typically far less open about, however, is her personal life. Ahead of the debut of Mary's book, Too Much and Never Enough, her uncle fought to have its release blocked, according to People magazine. His efforts were ultimately unsuccessful, and the book he deemed a disgrace raked in huge sales. Mary wrote of her grandparents, the former president's parents, Mary Trump and Fred Trump Sr., describing her grandmother as needy and her grandfather as seeming to, quote, have no emotional needs at all. She added, in fact, he was a high-functioning sociopath. Donald was one of five children, the second youngest, and his niece wrote, Donald developed a combative, rigid persona that he used in order to shield him from the terror of his early abandonment. Her father, Fred Trump Jr., was deemed the black sheep of the family and passed away at the age of 42 in 1981. She was a teenager when he died, and it seemed clear her early experiences living within the Trump family greatly impacted her personal life. As she transitioned to adulthood, the Simon & Schuster bio for Mary detailed that she spent a lot of time as a child in the Queens, New York home of her grandparents. Boston Spirit magazine noted she visited Cape Cod, Massachusetts frequently as well. When she was young, Mary realized she identified as part of the LGBTQ+ community. She told The Advocate in 2020 that there wasn't one particular moment that she pinpointed as a realization of that, and that it wasn't something she was comfortable with for quite some time. Mary also revealed she never discussed it with her family. She explained, I never came out to them. Even though homophobia wasn't really explicit in my family, growing up, no one talked about homosexuality one way or another. Mary added the Trump family was, in her words, anti-everything, against anything different from them. So she, quote, just assumed they were anti-gay, and that was something they would not tolerate.
Everything's about money in this family.
Mary recalled her grandmother sometimes said homophobic things, once using a slur as she noted it was a, quote, disgrace that Elton John was performing at Princess Diana's memorial. That moment solidified for Mary she couldn't open up to her family. Fred Trump Sr. died in June of 1999, and the timing was significant to Mary. His passing came a week prior to a trip to Hawaii, where she'd planned to marry her partner. Mary wrote in her best-selling book that her family hadn't known about the wedding or her fiancé. Mary attended Tufts University to study literature, and she earned a master's degree from Columbia University in English literature. According to the New York Times, Mary then shifted to focus on psychology at Adelphi University, where she ultimately earned both a master's degree and a doctorate. She taught graduate courses in psychology, and in addition to being a trained clinical psychologist, Forbes noted that she has provided life coaching as well. Although Mary has been protective of her private life, she mentioned in her book that she'd been married once. The two women divorced, but they have a daughter together named Avery. In May 2021, Mary shared a photo of Avery on Twitter for Mother's Day, writing, I am the luckiest person on the planet. Last spring, Mary joined the board of LPAC, an organization supporting LGBTQ+ female political candidates. According to Tag magazine, could she run for office herself someday? Interestingly, she doesn't rule it out. She quipped to the magazine, I have no idea because I think I need to sleep for a year first before I think of what I'm going to do next. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite celebs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.